Hello everybody, and welcome to another Pez card collection video. I see many new players confused as to what the four sets of numbers are that are shown before matches, comparing the two opposing teams. So in this video, I will be explaining to you all what they are, and how to raise them. But first, why not subscribe to the channel with notifications on so you'll be notified whenever new videos are uploaded. To start off with, these numbers all help determine match scaling. Match scaling is a feature that was added into Pez card collection that compares the total strength, grade, skills, and talents of your deck against the team that you are about to face, and then reduces the ability of 1 to 4 players from the team with the fewest wins. The bigger the difference in wins, the more players are nerfed, up to a total of 4 players. The players that get nerfed are indicated with a blue downwards arrow beside their card, and are chosen at random from the starting 11. No substitute cards can be nerfed. Now that you all know about match scaling, I will explain in a bit more detail what these numbers all mean and how you can raise yours. Total strength is the combined abilities of your starters and subs, plus team skill levels. Grade is the combined grade of all your starters and subs. If you don't know what grade is, it is the number at the bottom left of all player cards. Special skills and talents are where it gets a bit more complicated, because there are letter grades. Your special skills rank starts at C and goes to A, but with 10 levels per letter. So for example, C1, C2, C3, etc. To get from one rank to another, you need to pass a certain skill point threshold, and all special skills have a certain weight allotted to them. I'll put a chart up on the screen so you can see what it takes to get from one level to another. It all sounds rather complicated, but once you look at the chart, it is actually quite simple. For example, if you unlock an A rank skill on a card in your team, you receive 7 points towards your total special skill level. If you upgrade it to A+, it goes up to 8 points, and if it's maxed out at A++, it will count as 9 points. All the player skills you have within your starting 11 and subs is added up to a total number, and what that number is determines what rank will be displayed. So for example, if they all added up to 285, your rank would be A3. You can use the chart on screen to help you determine your team's total and when you will reach the next special skill rank. So far, the highest possible rank is A10, and you need at least 324 points to achieve it. Your talent rank follows the same principle, but it's quite a bit less complex. The letters and numbers stay the same, with them starting at C and going to A, with 10 numbers per letter, but the points per talent grade is a lot less complicated. There are only 4 different talent grades, as you can see on screen. A, which gives you 4 points, B, which gives you 3, C, which gives you 2, and D, which gives you 1. You simply add up all the points your team has, based on what talents are unlocked for your starters and subs, and then look at the bottom chart to see what level you'll be placed in, and how far you are from reaching the next level. So, for example, if you have 246 talent points, you'll be ranked A1. The higher you can get all of these numbers and ranks for your team, the better the odds you have to win the match. However, total strength is the most important thing to look at. Because if you start the match with a higher total strength than your opponent, if the match ends up in penalties, you have pretty much a 95% chance of winning the shootout, no matter how much worse your goalkeeper is or penalty kick takers are. If you rank higher than your opponent in any of these categories, there will be a blue circle beside it, but if you rank lower, there will be a red X, as you can see in the video. It is also worth noting that player skills for positions are a massive factor in determining the winner of the match. So if you're going into a match with a higher total strength than your opponent, but he has players with better skills than you do, you can still lose the match. That about covers everything for this video. Hopefully you now know a little bit more about match scaling, how to increase your chances at winning your matches, and what all the numbers mean when comparing two teams, plus how to raise them. If this video helped you out at all, please consider leaving a like. It helps us out a ton. And why not subscribe to the channel with notifications on so you will be notified whenever a new video is posted. Also, if you still have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments below. I'll be responding to all comments. But until next time, have a good one.